Chronic wasting disease is a fatal neurological disease found in the natural state's white-tailed deer and elk herds. CWD is caused by a protein that occurs naturally in animals. The disease usually isn't noticeable until the later stages of sickness, which makes CWD detection a challenge for wildlife managers in the 26 states and 4 countries where it's been found. The Arkansas Game and Fish Commission relies on the state's hunters for samples that are used for research and the development of CWD management plans.
Since 2016, since CWD was discovered in the state, our staff have worked very hard in collecting information, collecting data, collecting samples. And so the last deer season, 2020, Arkansas hunters submitted nearly 8,000 samples statewide. And so that gives us a lot of confidence as to where this disease is at and where it's not been detected.
CWD has changed deer hunting for some Arkansans. In counties in the CWD management zone where the disease is most prevalent, regulations have played a key role in managing the disease and preventing its spread to other parts of the state. Although there aren't any new CWD regulations for the 2021-2022 deer season, previous regulations regarding CWD remain in place. Current regulations can be found at agfc.com/CWD and also in the annual hunting regulations guidebook.
We ask that all hunters, of course, follow regulations. They're there in place for a reason, but also have your deer tested. That information, a positive test is just a value or as a negative test to us. We want a red dot just as well as we do a green dot on a map. For those hunters outside the CWD zone, testing is just as valuable to us. That we have quotas set aside for every county. We have certain targets. So when we reach those targets in those counties, we have a certain amount of confidence whether or not that disease is present or absent in that county. Our goal is to have free testing in every county of the state from the very beginning of deer season to the very last day of deer season, and we're accomplishing that goal. We have over 100 freezers located throughout the state, over 50 taxidermists, and you can go to agfc.com/CWD, and that'll take you straight to the page so you can learn all the information.
After voluntary samples are collected from game and fish drop-off locations, they're sent to a laboratory for testing.
We're working with our laboratory here in Arkansas. The Arkansas Department of Agriculture has a lab, and we're very fortunate to partner with them this year. So we're able to just submit samples directly to Little Rock. And normally turnaround times within about 7 days. We're trying our best to get that cut down even further. We understand that's an inconvenience to many of our hunters, but we just ask that you be patient with us, that especially during the high volume times of the year right after modern gun season. But we're going to work as hard as we can to get samples quickly. We will contact hunters if their results come back CWD positive, and we encourage hunters not to consume CWD positive deer. That's a recommendation from the Arkansas Department of Health and from the Center for Disease Control. And so we're going to ask that the hunter dispose of that meat, and we can help with the disposal of the positive meat.
More than 33,000 deer and elk have been tested in Arkansas since CWD was initially detected in 2016, with more than 1,000 samples testing positive for the disease. The 2020-2021 deer season marked the highest number of samples submitted by hunters.
Since CWD was identified in 2016, one of the overall missions for the Game and Fish is to partner with our hunters. That we realized chronic wasting disease was going to be a challenge to this state, and that there was no way that we could manage this disease without the partnership of our hunters. And I believe we've done that. I understand that it's an inconvenience. I understand that these regulations maybe displace some hunters or maybe altered the change of some hunters' habits. But we hope that the hunters understand the value of these regulations. But they have been a great partner to us. They've been submitting samples, and I'm very proud of how our hunters have stepped up and helped Game and Fish manage this disease.